folks! Woo! I think we're gonna get going. I want to say hello to everybody. My name is Paige, Clem, and thank you for the clapping. I'm the songwriter in residence here for the Bazaar Cafe this month. This is my third week in a row to do this, and November has 5 Tuesdays, so I'm really lucky to be able to host a whole bunch of artists. I think there's like 15 or 20 artists that I've been hosting throughout the month. I've got some posters over here that has the whole residency lineup, but we've got 2 more weeks to go, and I'll tell you a little bit later about the other artists that are going to be there. But tonight is the night that we're all excited about and here for. I'm just super honored to be standing here with these artists. I'm so excited that they're all here to play with some music with all of us. We have Roger McNamee. And Pat Nevins over here. And Jordan Feinstein signed. Right, Jordan's parents will be here later, so we can argue whether it's Feinstein or Feinstein with the parents. Apparently, it's fine for debate. I was thinking about that the other day. It's like, how do you actually know how you pronounce your name? Like, really? You know, like, where did it really come from? Maybe it got changed along the way. So, I actually there's a book of my family genealogy that's called the Clem book, and it's C-L-E-M-C-L-E-M-M-K-L-E. Yeah, anyway, I got into genealogy when I was in Utah, first of all. I'm going to tell you just real quickly what is super special about Bazaar Cafe is there's no amplification, except for things, I guess, maybe this kind of comes a little bit when you got to get a little bit of juice behind something. But in general, all the music here is all acoustic. And as you can see from this sign, and thanks to Les, it's all original music. No covers at the Bazaar Cafe. So everything you're going to hear tonight is coming straight from these artists. A lot of us, in fact, all of us play out in different configurations and different bands, and some of us play with tributes. Pat and I do, we sing in a Bob Dylan, Neil Young tribute band. Jordan and I play, we've all played Dev together. So, but tonight, it's all original music. So, really excited to have you here. And we're gonna play in the round and just kinda share with each other. And I'm gonna get it going here with a song called Buttercups. This is a song, actually, a post came up about this just the other day. I wrote this song a few years ago for a friend whose son was diagnosed with cancer when he was just like 3 years old. And he ended up going through 40 weeks of chemo, and now he's 6 years old and happy and healthy and cancer-free. But this song was kind of meant to be a pick-me-up song, and I think we'd all use a pick-me-up these days. Hey, little buttercup, 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 you got this. It's gonna be all you can see, you are. counterclockwise. We'll go ahead and pass it off to Roger, and we'll keep going in the round.
Well, so I've been reading lately that music is supposed to help us through hard times. And we're going to run that experiment right now. I can't speak for all of you, but I need it to work for me tonight, too. So I picked a set of songs that are all thematically appropriate to what's happened to us in the last week. Okay? And so I hope you'll be tolerant, and I hope you'll like them. Now, I was asked, would I please play Hallelujah for Leonard Cohen? And of course, we can't do that because we can't do covers. But it turns out that I wrote a song for Leonard without realizing. And so that's what I'm going to play now. It's called No Tomorrow.
Leonard, I'd better met you when you gazed into my soul. Played the hand that you were dealt, turning deuces into gold. Well, you left a trail of breadcrumbs to guide me on my way. Words on wrinkled paper worth more than I can pay. Saddle up the ponies, let's get away from right where daylight takes us, hold each moment dear. Love and live the journey, every sense aglow. Does there maybe no tomorrow? And if not, we'll never know. Then you shared life's prism, wavelengths of a dream, with many facets, a face, a back, a team. Could you have imagined, can you imagine now, how bright your light keeps shining after you've left? Saddle up the ponies, let's get away from here. Right where daylight takes us, hold each moment dear. Live and love the journey, every sense aglow. 'Cause there may be no tomorrow, and if not, never know. Nothing to do, no one to call, no stunning vista or high waterfall. Well, it's none of my business, I'm a fly on the wall. You need to change your attitude, dispense with all the platitudes, learn a little gratitude now. Leonard, the words you left behind put my fears to rest. Last I heard your ship had sailed, it was heading west. Well, I cannot say for certain that our paths will cross again, but I surely hope to see you up around the bend. Saddle up the ponies, let's get away from here. Right where daylight takes us, hold each moment dear. Love and live the journey, every sense aglow. 'Cause there may be no tomorrow, we'll never know.
places, so he's not over here like, nobody puts baby in the corner. Nobody puts Pat in the corner.
Ah, you mean there's Pat?
I do.
Look, he actually is here.
I thought it was a rumor.
Keep talking for a second, Kate. I saw you tune this guitar.
Keep talking? Let's see, I can talk. Who wants to banter? Do you have any Danny here for some banter?
As long as you can sit here.
I'll tell you guys real quick about my other two shows that are coming up next 2 Tuesdays. Next week, we have three other songwriters. We've got Scott Griffin Padden from Goodnight Texas, a guy named Tom Sway. If you haven't seen Tom Sway, just please come out and check him out. He's just a very unique songwriter. It's like each song is like an entire Broadway musical. And it's lots of emotion and drama and words, and it's like super captivating. It's really, really fun. And then Cello Joe is going to come, and he plays around town and with the tons of folks and does really cool things with a cello and loops and beatboxing, stuff like that. So really eclectic group next week. And then the last week of the month is going to be Kelly Jane and Tim McCaffrey from the Little Fuller Band. They're up out of the Sierras, a great bluegrass band, and they're going to come do some of their original music. And then also with Michael McNevin, who's based out of the South Bay, or East South Bay, Niles Canyon. Really prolific songwriter, won a lot of awards, just a really great storyteller. Good vibes. So that's the next 2 Tuesdays. How'd I do? All right, perfect.
Sorry for the delay, folks. My name is Pat. Like, I play a lot of Neil Young and Bob Dylan tunes. It's been in some dead bands, but it's good to be here with you guys tonight. Playing some songs. I'm not the most prolific songwriter, but I got a few.
She was working on the night shift at a truck stop in Portland, Maine. He was 19 and a ways back then, my memory was starting to fade. She was taking orders for coffee, bacon, and scrambled eggs. I was leaning on the crossing sign parking lot when midnight came. Down by the railroad tracks, I was a little hazy that day. The sun raced to the sky, the fog was turning everything gray.
Lead event called Jordan and the Rituals. Some of you have seen. I actually recognize a lot of people from maybe Terrapin or there, here or there. I don't do this. Usually I have 12 or 13 people on stage and like almost like a gospel choir. I have seven women singing with me. So going to do semi-solo. They're going to play with me, but you guys are the backup singers tonight. And you'll notice that every song of mine, there's a very obvious chorus that you can sing and just totally get the first time through, and I'll probably explain it. Okay? So, my first song is called Hello to Me. It's an intro song. And it's usually done reggae, and I do sometimes with a reggae beat on here, but she didn't like that last time, so I'm going to leave off the reggae beat. And hope you guys can just see that chuk, chuk, chuk. And maybe more country from that because of that.
I knew I wore my cowboy boots.
I know,
for
this
a
is the
reason.
Best dolphin floor around.
So, usually, that's where it goes like this.
Why don't you say, why don't you say, hello to me,
hello to me.
Why don't you say,
why don't you say,
hello to me,
hello to me.
Why don't you say,
why don't you say,
hello to me.
Might not do what?
Mighty God above expects of me to
A lot of things this year, and again, I wrote the song a few years ago, but I would have been really proud if I'd written it this week. It's called Angle of Repose.
This morning caught me by surprise. Another question answered. A hungry baby cries. City lights still shimmer as traffic weaves its way. Life goes on, but not the same. Different today. My mind, your love is me, young man finding gold. In every situation, your warmth would melt the cold. I tried to share my greatest gift, put your mind at ease. Worry that I may have missed the forest and the trees. Let your burden disappear. Let the door swing closed. No more struggle, no more fear at your angle of repose. Sun came up this morning, stillness in the air. Another answer question, a hungry truth laid bare. Your lighthouse fire guides me here from far away. Your melodies inspire me when emotions fray. Let your burdens disappear. Your angle of repose. if the sun comes up tomorrow, will I be there all day? Another puzzle fragment, another game to play. My wattage isn't epic, so hear me when I say, I hope in time to shine as bright as you shine today. Let your burdens disappear. Let the door swing closed. No more struggle, no more fear at your end.
This one would clock in at about 13 years. So, there's nobody in this room that knows this person.
Just so you know, we are broadcasting live on Facebook. Yeah.
She's not my friend on Facebook either.
Well,
she is true.
She might be my wife, yeah. Meet almost famous back there.
Things that cry so many
studio. She's like, so what are you gonna do about the bowling pins? There's all these like sounds of a bowling alley. Okay, and it's called Set Him Up or Set Me Up and Knock Me Down Again, and it's about bowling, it's not about bowling. So you guys are gonna do the backup singing. Really easy. All Oz. You can do Oz, yeah? What part is this?
change with the stare. Join the league and grease your hair. It's the finale that makes us the gods.
Songwriter named Steve Pultz, and everyone should go see Steve Pultz. He's actually going to be at the Great American on March 9th or something like that. Go look at Steve Pultz or Pultz.com. Amazing songwriter, will change your life in one night. But Steve can write a song about anything, and I have another friend that's a songwriter friend that knows him. Most of my songwriter friends know him. And something came up about this guy's grocery list, and he had kombucha and condoms on it. And I said, kombucha and condoms, that could be a Steve Pultz song. And then a little while later, a couple of weeks later, something came up about, there was a mistake in a typing, texting thing, where we got the word parts and pants mixed up, and it got really weird for a second. And I said, that could be part of the song. And so for fun, I texted him a little verse, and he was like, that's amazing. And so then I went back and wrote the whole song. And now it's become like my favorite song. So this is Kombucha and Condoms. It's actually Jordan's favorite too.
Thank you. weaponry, they always fall apart. I reached out to touch her arm. She held my head to her breast. Now who knows where we are? I'm looking around for a landmark. But when I find it, I'll send a postcard.
Last few songs have been pretty intimidating.
Oh, come on, Roger.
But you know, I'm really lucky because I married somebody who knows a lot more about songwriting than I do. And I wrote some chords a number of years ago, and my lovely wife Ann turned it into a song. And then, amazingly, the person who discovered it is here tonight. So, Tracy, this is for you.
Shines distant, beacon in the night. Constellations burning, beckoning light. Trouble of an eye. Mountains of rain reflect the pain. We hear the swirling of the wind. Clouds of tears undiminished by over and over again. Raining down to the ground, stars fall from the sky. Life is changed, rearranged in the blink of an eye. Raining down to the ground, stars fall.
think about this playing straight through? It's gonna get a break while we're sitting, right?
We need a break.
We need a break. You need a break. Okay. All right. We'll do one. We'll just we'll finish up this round and then we'll take a break. Which needs better?
So I dropped out of college to follow the Grateful Dead around.
Woo!
Yeah.
I'm so glad I did that. And like, you know, I played in a bunch of Dead bands, the Dead Beats in Chicago, that I'm gonna play some songs from that kind of era of my thing. Actually, what am I talking about? That's what I'm doing. I'm gonna do one of those right now. I sound like Bob Weir. And that's like the thing, I was in Dead bands and I wanted to write Bob Weir songs because like I thought, you know, he was as important as Jerry was, even though I was following Jerry around, you know, like everything.
But
I was really into Bob and his style of songwriting. And so I wrote like three songs that were sort of in that, you know, 70s, 80s Bob Weir world that were like chords all over the place and you could get lost really easily. Trying to come up with one. Yeah. You could get lost in him, he could get lost.
Yeah.
He did. I did. So we used to do this one like out of playing in the band. We would do playing in the band and long jam, and then this thing would come flying out of it. It was a Dead Beats tune that I wrote. It's called Something Someday. I haven't played it in a long time, and it actually, like, it's about, you know, it's still, I surprise myself with songs that I wrote. This is like 25 years old, this song is, and so I'm writing about, you know, a Mexican girl trying to get across the border with her parents as a little girl into the United States because they wanted to be there, because she wanted to be something someday. So when I looked at it today, I was like, I should really do that because it sort of stood the test of time, like kind of some of the Bob Dylan, Neil Young tunes stand that test of time. Maybe this one will. You won't know the lyrics. I hope I remember them. And, again, I was trying to write weird, easy Bob style too.
Weird, easy?
Bob Weir style. Across the border at 3:00.
like. And I want to just do a couple of housekeeping things. I'm going to go ahead and start the magic felted tip jar. Think of all the musicians that have been paid out of this bucket over the years. So this is a no-cover venue, but anything you put in here will help the musicians pay their bills and get home and things like that. So I'm going to just start this around over here. And then when we're, as soon as this sets, as soon as we do Jordan's song, before we break, I'd like to get a selfie with everybody, and we'll get a little group shot of everybody. So maybe Bob will want to come up here and get a good group crowd shot for it. So let's see what Jordan's got, though. And then we're just going to take a super short break because we don't have a lot of time tonight. We're only going until 9:30, so we'll probably break for like 5 minutes at the most and then come back.
That was awesome. Yeah. Paige's Facebook friends with Bob Wearing just wrote it. He's like, wait a minute, that's my song.
Yeah, he's like, hey, did I write that?
Like, I think I may remember writing that. You guys want to go up or down?
Do we want to end on a cheery note or a down note?
Up, 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 up. Up. We need all the upgrades to get these days.
Jordan does this no matter what. Like, one time I went over to his house to, like, play music with him. I thought I was going to play my songs. And before he would let me play my songs, he made me learn how to play his drum kit. Like, he literally, like, made me take a drum lesson before I could even share my songs. So everybody, it's always about participating.
And the other thing about Jordan, he was going to play the same song whether we said up or
down. If you hire someone's stage manager, is that how it's going to be?
You just have to wait for it, that's all.
Oh, no.
You don't have to pay for it.
Okay. Yeah.
And then it's a call and response. So, he's just like, oh.
So, okay, this one is called Phone Train to Ride. We got you guys done.
Okay. Be quiet. He's shushing you. STFU.
Yeah, who's got a t-shirt when you need it?
Okay, so this next one is called Own Train Ride, or Got My Own Train Ride. So, you guys know Brett Denon, right?
Yeah!
So I played with him a bunch of times at Sierra and stuff like that, and we really super connected musically, but interpersonally wasn't really there. And so he wound up taking a bunch of my friends on tour, but not me, and I was very hurt by this at the time. And so I see, like, a bunch of friends that are, like, a couple weeks later, like, sorry, you all I'm going on Brett tour? I'm like, forget Brett Denon, I got my own train of ride. So that became the song. Also, in the song, I say Frisco, because I don't think there's anything wrong with calling San Francisco Frisco.
So you're saying it's a down song, not an up.
Yeah.
You said I was going to do whatever.
Just one foot in the hole, and
now.
Just prepare. Oh, wait.
Yeah.
There's a part. You guys get a part.
Oh, you don't know. They'll figure it out.
We don't have to say Frisco, do we?
Whatever he says, you say after he says
it. Of course, I say got my own train to ride, you say got my own train to ride. And then there's a last line, which she'll tell you.
Woo!
about what you're doing, but I wonder where you are. Maybe you're playing in the garden, open up a child singing when I go. Or I'm California. Like I said, I just don't know.
That's one of the things bobbed up.